Good morning everyone. So today I'm going to teach about the subject biology. So in the biology, the chapter I'm going to teach about is about the animal kingdom. Okay, so this is the subject called biology. So to know about the biology, we have to know the first what is the meaning of biology. So before entering into the subject, we should know about the meaning of the subject, okay? Then only there will be use of what is the chapter. So what is this term biology? Biology is nothing but dealing with the living things and non-living things. And there is another one definition, that is the study of life forms. Okay, so the biology is nothing but it is the dealing with the study of the living process and also the non-living process and also the study of life forms. Okay, now you have the idea what is biology, right? Okay. Now, who was the first who named this term biology? Nothing but the author called Lamarck and the Tavernes in the 1801. So, the Lamarck and Tavernes was the one who named this term biology. So, now you know what is the biology, okay? So now, what is biology? Biology, so it have the two divisions, right? Botany and zoology. So what is this botany and zoology? So botany is nothing but the study of plants and zoology is nothing but the study of animals. So the study of plants, this term botany was termed by the author called Theophrastus and the term zoology is termed by the author called Aristotle. Okay, so this the father of biology is called Aristotle. Okay, who is this Aristotle? So who is the father of biology? So this is not under the subject, it's actually a general knowledge. You have to know, okay, who is the father of biology? If someone asks you, you have to say Aristotle is the father of biology. So what is this word bios means? So bios is the nothing but the Greek word, okay? All these authors were from the, okay, all those authors, you know, okay? These authors are from the Greek land. They are from the Greek word Sweden. Okay. So they actually written all those names in the Greek word. So this actually the biology is also a Greek word where it came Greek word called bios and logos. So the bios logos is the Greek word from where the term biology is derived. Okay. What does this bios mean? Bios means life and logos means study. Okay, so bios means life and logos means study. So studying about the life is called as biology. So now you can able to understand what is the meaning of biology. Okay, so now let us enter into the what? Now let us enter the chapter. Okay, now let us know what is the kingdom. So this chapter is all about animal kingdom, right? So kingdom na enna? What is this kingdom? So whenever we take about this kingdom, there will be lots of questions. What is this kingdom? Okay, nothing but the organisms, the species that is present in all over the world. What are all these species? What is the species mean? The animals, plants, fishes, the sea animals. So all this plants, trees, little shrubs, herbs, the insects, the reptiles, everything comes under the kingdom. So when you take about the forest, there will be many plants, there will be many trees, there will be many shrubs, herbs, and also there will be many types of plants and animals also. Okay, like that, there are not only in the forest, there are all around the world. Even in the day-to-day life, we are living with animals. Who? Dogs, cats. So you all this see in the day-to-day life, right? All this whole universe. So studying about all these things is the species. So nothing but the species is nothing but the every organism that is present in the world is called as species. Okay. Now let us not confuse between the species and the spices. Okay, I know everyone will have the pronunciation difficulty and they will say species as spices, spices. So let us not get confused in between that. Okay, species is nothing but the living organisms. Okay, and also non-living. But the spices is the one we eat. What are all the spices? The elaichi, the jeera, the cardamom, all this comes under the spices. Okay, let us not get confused between these species and the spices. So, you will have the idea what is spices now. Okay, so what is species that we are familiar with? So, what are all the species that I have came through? They can be monkeys, parrots, cats, and also we saw all these animals in forest. So, where is this forest in Chennai? It is in Vandalur Zoo. Okay. So, where is the zoo? So, we can all this see these animals in the zoo. Okay. So, where is this zoo? Have you anybody visited Vandalur Zoo? You can able to see many types of animals there. So, if you get a chance, please have a visit to the Vandalur Zoo. So, what happens is we can able to see lots of animals like this. Okay, so the animals, what are all the animals that is present in the surroundings? They can be cat, goat, hen, cow, cat, so dog, so many things. All this we can see nearby our homes or nearby villages, we can see this. But wild animals, all these wild animals we can able to see only in the forest. They are also the types of fish species. Okay, and microbes, what is this microorganisms? So, microorganisms is nothing but the virus, bacteria, fungi, protists. So, what are all this? So, these are the minute organisms that are invisible to our eyes. Okay, these are also the organisms but we can't see. Okay, what are all the organisms? They are called as microbes. Okay, what are all the microbes? They are virus, bacteria, fungi and protists. Okay, and reptiles. What are all the reptiles we can see? The snake, the crocodile, the lizards that actually swell on the floor. They are all the reptiles and also on the walls. And insects. What are all the insects? The ant, the bees, the butterflies, the bugs, the worms, hookworms, earthworms, all this also the kind of species. Okay, I actually showing this each and everything because you have to understand the meaning of species. What are all the categories that comes under this species? That's why I am actually explaining you in the particular slides so that you can understand what is the species. Okay, and next, plants, trees. So, there are many plants, mango tree, neem tree, all these trees, all these small plants, all these lotus plants, all this comes under the species. And birds. So, what are all the birds we are familiar with? The peacock, the national bird is the peacock. Okay, the national animal is tiger. So, likewise, we can able to know the pigeon, okay, many types of birds, all comes under the birds. That is species category. And what another species? That is fishes. So many types of whales, shark, many types of golden fishes, sea animals, crabs, all this dolphin, sea, charfish, jellyfish, all this comes under the species. And finally, the human beings. Human beings are also the species. So now you know what this particular species organisms means. Okay. So now let us know the classification of species. Okay. You can ask the question, why we want to classify the species, ma'am? So what happens is we cannot treat the each and every one species particularly, right? Because there are millions of species. How many? 1.5 million of species around the world. We cannot study. How we can study? We can classify them. We can put it in a particular group and we can study easily. So that is why they have classified. And that classification, so that study of classification of wide variety of organisms is called as taxonomy. Taxo means classifying organisms and nomi means study. So the study of classifying, so putting into the many groups. So we are classifying the species into many groups. That is the called as taxonomy. So the study of classifying the organisms, wide variety of organisms, the study of classification of wide variety of organisms is called as taxonomy. Okay, now let us know the history. How this history? So starting, there will be many authors who classify this organizations or classify these organisms, right? So let us know who and all classify these organisms. So let us know the history of classification. So who classified this? The author called Carl Linnaeus or Carolus Linnaeus. So the Carolus Linnaeus is the author who actually classified this into the first author who classified this taxonomy. So he is also called as the father of modern taxonomy. Who is called as father of modern taxonomy? Carolus Linnaeus or Carl Linnaeus. Both is the same author, same name only. Okay, you can also say as Carl Linnaeus or Carolus Linnaeus. Okay, who is he? So he is the Sweden botanist. Okay, in 1758 he actually generated the terms for the, he actually divided the whole animal kingdom, the whole kingdom into two types, that is Plantae and Animalia. So what he did is, he did only two types of division, that is Plantae means all types of plants, trees, and Animalia is all types of plants, so all types of animals. Okay. Next, in the year 1969, R.H. Whittaker. R.H. Whittaker, he is the American plant ecologist. What he did is, he proposed the first five kingdom of classification. He classified the species into five kingdoms. What are all the kingdoms? They are Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. What are all the kingdoms? Fungi, Protista, Plantae, Animalia. Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. Okay, what is this Monera? All these things are, they are classified based on the prokaryotes, eukaryotes. So what is this prokaryotes and eukaryotes? Prokaryote means single cell organisms. Eukaryotes means multicellular organisms. So prokaryotes means single cell and eukaryote means multicell. And also they are classified on the based on cell wall, body organization and the mode of nutrition. So they are classified the five Whittaker's kingdoms of classification. You just have to write what are all the five kingdom of Whittaker classification. Five kingdom of classification you have to write: Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. Right? You understood this? And next, Carl Woese in 1919, he is an American biologist. What he did is, he classified this kingdoms of classification into seven types. What? How many types? Seven kingdom of classification. So this is the seven kingdom of classification that is accepted wide variety, right? So this is actually accepted in wide variety. So what are all this? Kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus and species. Seven kingdoms. Okay, what are all the seven kingdoms? Kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus and species. So let us know the types. So what is this kingdom? What is this class? So let us know the particular what are all the categories that comes under the seven kingdoms, and let us know what is the meaning of the particular classification. So first let us start from the species. Why we want to start from the species is, species is the smallest category of organism which we have classified. So from this species we will come to know what is the kingdom. Okay, so now let us know about this species. So this species comes under the lowest taxonomic category. So in this, how the species are classified is based on the uniqueness. So the unique quality of the any species. For example, if you take a dog, it is unique, it is original. Okay. Likewise, if you take a parrot and the parakeet is nothing but the lovebirds. Okay, that is called as parakeet. So the parrot comes from the different origin, and the parakeet comes from the different origin, and they can't be interbreeded. That is the species. Okay, they are the lowest taxonomic category. And if somebody asks you example, there is parrot and parakeet. And the next one is genus. So what is genus means is the closely related species. Closely related species means the resemblance. When you take the example of the dogs, the wolf and the jackal. So when you take the example of the dog, wolf and jackal, you can have the resemblance of same resemblance that comes under the genus, that is dogs, wolf and jackals. So they come under the category called canis. Okay, the dog, the wolf and the jackal resembles as a closely related species. So that comes under the topic called genus, that is the classification. Next, family. So what is this family? This family is nothing but the general common characters. Now we saw the closely related species, and now we are seeing about the general common characters. What are all the characters? Whenever we see a cat, it resembles like a tiger is sitting, right? So that character, so that type of character, even the eyes, the skin shades, you can see the example of cheetah, leopard and jaguar, all the skin shades and all will be same. That comes under the category called family. So they are called as Felidae. Okay. And next comes the category called order. What this order means is the monkey, baboons, ape and man. So we have studied about the human evolution. How this human evolved? It evolved from the monkey, monkey to baboons, baboons to ape and ape to man. So that is the total called primates. They come under the category of primates. So now you understand the order. So you can know that the man does not evolve startingly as a man. He evolved from the monkey. Monkey to baboons, baboons to ape, and ape is also a category of monkey. Okay. So monkey to a man. So you can able to differentiate this. Okay. Now the next category is the class. So what this, the common, the cat in this feature, in this class classification, all the organisms have the common feature. What is that feature means? Mammalians. Mammalians have the mammary glands. What is this mammary glands? Is nothing but the organ that is used to feed the young ones. For example, the cow is feeding their young calf. The monkey will feed their young monkeys. All this comes under the mammalians. Even the whale. Whale is the only amphibian, only sea animal that actually have the mammary glands and feed their young ones, young male. Okay. So what are all the examples? Rabbit, rat, bats, whales, chimpanzee, human, all comes under the category called mammalians. Okay. Now the next one is the phylum. So phylum is nothing but the related classes. So the what are all the phylum is nothing but the no backbone present animals and the without the backbone animals. So backbone, keeping this backbone, we can actually classify this phylum into two types, that is in the presence of notochord and not presence of notochord. So what is this notochord? Notochord is nothing but the backbone. So what are the animals that possess the notochord? Fish. So whenever you eat a fish, you can able to see that backbone. So that is the notochord. So it also present in the fish and also in the goat, dogs, and many example I have given. So all this category contains the backbone animals. And also human possess the backbone. So by differentiating this backbone, we can actually put it into a class category. And finally, it comes the kingdom. So kingdom is nothing but the largest category where every plants, animal, species, human beings, everything is classified. So that is the kingdom. So now you can have the idea what is the kingdom. So kingdom is nothing but the whole type of largest organization where the plants, animals, species, everything is classified. And the phylum is classified on based on the chordate. Chordate is nothing but the notochord. And the class is the mammalian classes where the mothers able to feed the young ones. That is the class. And order is nothing but the carnivora. That is from the monkey to the baboons to the ape. And finally the man is evolved. That is the order. And finally the family. Family is nothing but the cat, tiger. So the resemblance, the same resemblance and the same character, that is family canidae. And finally, the genus is nothing but the dog, wolf and jackal who have the resemblance of same, that is genus, that is canis family. And finally, the species familiaris, that is the parrot and the parakeet category. So now you can able to understand what is this seven kingdoms of classification. That is kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus and species. Okay, now the basis of classification of animal kingdom. So now we know about the kingdom. So let us know about the particular animal kingdom. So what is this animal kingdom and how they are classified? This animal kingdom is classified into five categories. Okay. Only now let us not know about the plant, species, nothing. So let us know about the animal kingdom because this subject is all about the animal kingdom, right? So how this animal kingdom classification is done is, this animal kingdom is classified based on levels of organization, that is levels of organization, symmetry, germ layers, nature of coelom, notochord. Okay, so what are all the levels of organization? What is this levels of organization means is based on the cells. So there are two types of cells. Again, I said from the monera and protista how they are classified. Likewise, there are two types of cells, that is unicellular and multicellular. So uni means one and cellular means cells. Likewise, multi means many, cellular means cells. So this unicellular organisms is called prokaryotes. 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 Prokaryote means unicellular organisms. What are all the unicellular organisms? Amoeba, paramecium, euglenum. All this you have studied in the lower classes. Okay. All this comes under the unicellular organisms. What is the unicellular? Prokaryotes is the unicellular organisms. And next, multicellular. What is the multicellular? They are eukaryotes. That means many cell organisms. So what are all the organisms that comes under eukaryotes is what? Everything that is animals, human beings, so all the organisms, snakes, reptiles, all this comes under the eukaryotes. Okay, that is multicellular organisms. So now you know about the levels of organization, that is based on the unicellular or multicellular, that is cell classification. Okay, see, I have given another example, what is the single cell and what is the multicell. So based on the levels of organization, there are two divisions. And next, let us know about the symmetry. So they are classified on the basis of symmetry. What is this symmetry? that is the plane of arrangement of body part. So how this body part is arranged, to study, to know about that, it is classified into two symmetry, radial symmetry and bilateral symmetry. So what is this radial symmetry? Radial symmetry means whenever you cut the organisms into any symmetry, you can have the same resemblance. Okay, for example, if you cut a round shaped circle, okay, if you cut a round shaped circle, you can see the half of the parts resemble same. Likewise, if you cut in the any plane, that is transverse plane, horizontal plane, cross plane, in any plane, all the resemblance of the structure will be same in both the sides. But in the case of bilateral symmetry, if you cut in only, that is mid plane, if you cut in mid plane, the resemblance will be same. For example, if you take a human body, if you cut from the mid plane, the right and left side will be same. But if you cut from the horizontal plane, the upper and lower body will not be same, right? So that is the what symmetry? Bilateral symmetry, and this is the radial symmetry. So now you understand the symmetry. So there are two types. Excuse me. Radial symmetry and bilateral symmetry. Radial symmetry example is starfish and jellyfish, and bilateral symmetry is goat, human beings, anything you can take, okay. And next, on the germ layers. So based on the germ layers, so what is this germ layers? The layers that is present outside, inside and inner layer. So that is the germ layers. So what are all the layers is? So they are formed during the development of embryo. What is this embryo? So when you born inside the womb of the mother, at that stage itself, this germ layers started evolving. So what are all the types of the germ layers is? They are diploblastic and triploblastic, right? Diploblastic means double layered organisms. Double layered means only two layers, okay, that is diploblastic. And triploblastic means triple layered, that is three layered organisms. So the diploblastic example is hydra and triploblastic example is rabbit. So the hydra have only two layers. So what are all the layers? So let us know about the layers. The outer layer is called ectoderm. The middle layer is called mesoderm and the inner layer is called endoderm. So there are, based on these three layers, this is differentiated. This derm layers is differentiated. That is diploblastic or triploblastic. Okay, so the outer layer is called ectoderm, the middle layer is called mesoderm and the inner layer is called endoderm. And finally, about the coelom. So the coelom, again, what is the meaning of the coelom? Coelom is nothing but the body fluid filled cavity. So the fluid filled cavity, where this fluid filled cavity present is in between the digestive tract of the body and separating, it actually present in between, where it actually separates the upper body wall and lower digestive tract body. So it present actually in the middle. So what is this coelom? Why this coelom is evolving? Because in many of the animals, there will be absent of coelom. But in lots of animals, there will be coelom present. So on the basis of this also, the animals are categorized, right? So how the coelom animals are classified is, there are three types of coelom, that is acoelomates, pseudocoelomates and eucoelomates or coelomates. There are three types. What is this acoelomates means? Acoelomates means absent of coelom. A means that is absent. Okay. So whenever there is no body cavity in coelom, that means acoelomates. Pseudocoelomates. Pseudocoelomates means the false cavity. That means the circle will be present, but it is not the true coelom. that is called as pseudocoelomates, that is the false body cavity. And finally, the eucoelomates or coelomates. So what is this eucoelomates mean? The true body cavity, that is the complete body cavity, the true coelom, the original coelom that is present. So what is this coelom? The body fluid filled cavity that actually separates the body wall from the digestive tract. That is the coelom. So let us know the example. Okay, what this acoelom, pseudocoelom and eucoelom means. So for example, if you take a flatworm, you can able to see there is no coelom, right? It is actually a flat. That is called as acoelomates. And if you take a pseudocoelomate example, that is roundworms, you can able to see they are round in circle, but they are actually does not have the coeloms. So that is called as pseudocoelomates. And finally, eucoelom. What is the eucoelom? The true coelom. You can able to see the coelom structure here in the annelida. So the annelida is an insect, the worm that contains actually the true coelom. So you will have the example, and now you know the idea what is the coelom and what are all the types of coelom. So there are three types: acoelomates, pseudocoelomates, and eucoelomates. And also this is divided into, and also it is further classified based on the notochord. Notochord is nothing but, I've already said about the phylum category, phylum chordata. So chordate means notochord, nothing but the backbone. So on the basis of the backbone, it is actually classified two types, that is intervertebrates or chordates. That is, we can also say as non-chordates or chordates. Non-chordates means the backbone is absent. So there are lots of animals where they do not have the backbone, and there are also the animals where they have backbone. So what are all the animals that have the backbone and what are all the animals which do not have the backbone? So intervertebrates, that is flatworms, jellyfish, starfish, shrimps, spider, scallop, snail. So all these categories, they do not have the backbone, so they are differentiated as intervertebrates. But those animals, like what are all the animals? Reptiles, birds, mammals, human, amphibians, fishes, they have notochord present. So they are differentiated as vertebrate animals. So there are two types of animals, that is vertebrates and intervertebrates. So now you have the idea actually what are all the classification. So let me repeat once again, what are all the, how the animals are classified and on what basis. So they are classified on the basis of levels of organization, that is whether they are unicellular or multicellular, and symmetry, that is the bilateral or radial symmetry, and germ layers, that is diploblastic or triploblastic, and nature of the coelom, that is acoelom, pseudocoelom or eucoelom, and on the basis of notochord, that is chordates or non-chordates, and you can also say it as vertebrates or intervertebrates. Now you can have the idea how they are classified, right? Okay, now let us know about the naming. So how to name these animals? I've already said that they are actually in the Greek word or Latin word. So we also have to know about the binomial nomenclature, that is naming the animals. So who this binomial nomenclature introduced? Again, the Carolus Linnaeus, okay? He actually introduced this binomial nomenclature. So what is this binomial nomenclature? So the method of naming the plants and the animals. So how we name the plants? On the basis of genus and species. Okay, we actually name, there are two names for one plant. That is genus name and species name. Okay, that is why there are two names, that is they have actually given in two names, that is genus and species. So while writing, how we should understand which is the genus name and which is the species name? how we should differentiate is the genus name always we should return write the first letter in the capital, and the species name we always have to write the first letter in the small letter. So whatever the name that is having the first letter as the capital, then that is the genus name, and the second word that is the small letter, the starting letter should be small letter, then it should be differentiated as species. So now you can identify what is the genus and species. For example, let us know the example amoeba. So if you take the amoeba, the scientific name of amoeba is Amoeba proteus. So the first word will be genus and the second word will be species. So in this first letter, the capital A. So we have to write in capital letter A, and the second word first letter we have to write in small letter. This is actually the amoeba, the big letter, that is the capital letter, denotes the genus name, and the small letter in the second word denotes the species name. And also Hydra vulgaris, you can also see the first letter here and differentiate which is the genus and species name. And tapeworm, Tinea solium. Man, Homo sapiens. Cat, Felis felis. So while writing in the note also, whenever you write the scientific name, you have to write the first letter in the capital and the second word first letter as the small, that is the genus and the species name. So who this binomial nomenclature introduced? Carolus Linnaeus. So again I have written about the scientific rules. So what the scientific rule tells is the genus is capitalized and return first, and the species is the lower case and it is written in Latin. So while writing, you cannot write in Latin, right? So that is, you cannot write in slanting words, it cannot be italicized. So you have to underline while writing. So you have to underline the genus and the species, and you have to write the first letter in the capital and the second word first letter in the small letter. So this is what the animal kingdom classification and the how they are classified, and the what is the concept of the binomial nomenclature, and how we actually have to write the scientific name. Thank you.